It's time for The Match Game, Hollywood Squares, Hour with, from Three's Company, Richard Kline. From Too Close for Comfort, Lydia Cornell. From Auto Man, Chuck Wagner. Leonard Fry. Phyllis Diller. And the stars of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Gene Rayburn.
Clapping with his feet. Did you see that?
That's right.
There's a kid clapping
everything
with
together
his feet
out there. Well, we thank you for showing up here, and we thank you for all being here. I've got to investigate this. Phyllis, darling. What happened to your hair?
Well, it's so cold in my dressing room, it froze.
May I touch it?
Yes. Yeah. I'd love you to touch it.
Are you related to R2-D2?
I look that far out.
Yes, right. That's great. You're metallic.
Oh, yeah.
Your pants are metallic.
Oh,
everything.
Michael Jackson, eat your heart out. Two.
You have two, right. Well, I've always said you had two, but anyway. shall we greet our players over here with a brisk round of applause? We have Marla Braswell and Mike Gill. Yeah. Okay. Let's get acquainted with these two people. Marla, what about you?
I'm from Long Beach, California, and I'm happily married most of the time. And I'm assistant merchandise manager for a chain of convenience stores. I love to jog, and I'm proud of the fact I run 8 miles every morning.
8 miles every morning. You're in great shape. Good cardiovascular workout. And
feels good.
Yes. May I touch your body? Yes, right, yeah. Great, firm, wonderful. All right, Marla. May I touch you, Mike?
Sure.
I'm only kidding. What about your life, Mike? Where are you from and all that?
Well, I'm a loan officer for a major financial corporation in Los Banos, California. I'm married, and when I'm not at my loan company, you usually find me on a golf course or a baseball diamond somewhere.
Well, I was going to say, you are an outdoors person because you notice this, from here down he's tan, from here up he's not tan.
That's from the golf cap and the baseball caps.
I figured something like that. All right, good luck to both of you. We'll begin the match game now. And the winner of the match game will go on to challenge a returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Here we go, Marla. You won the toss, so you'll go first. You have a choice there of A or B.
B, please.
B it is for you. All right, B says, Lyle said ever since my wife got bitten by that Beverly Hills poodle, she's been acting weird. All she does now is sit up and beg for blank. The operative words are Beverly Hills poodle. All she does now is sit up and red. Here we go. Ready, Phyllis? Ready, John?
No, but...
You're not ready.
No, but go ahead. I will be by the time you get over there. Here.
You got one.
Yeah.
All right, Marla. Lyle said, ever since my wife got bitten by that Beverly Hills poodle, she's been acting weird. All she does now is sit up and beg for...
Gucci bags?
Gucci bags, right. All right.
That's good.
Anything Beverly Hillsy?
Sorry, mine was just more general. Money.
Money, right. All right.
You boo money?
Yes, well, they're weird.
I figure if she's begging...
Yes.
She's trying to satisfy a need for food.
Food.
So my mind went food, Beverly Hills parties, food. I went with caviar.
Oh, very good. That's now, that's Beverly Hillsy. Okay.
Oy vey. I said.
Oy vey.
Who knew?
Yeah, who knew?
I said. I wear work with Arnie Sultan. I said money, but I was going to say a permanent or a curly hairdo.
A hairdo, yeah.
Because it's a poodle.
But right. I didn't.
Right. By a poodle, yes, oy vey.
Whatever that tape means. Delay.
And thank she speaks audience. Fluent Spanish, too. What do you got for us, John?
I said a mink coat.
All right. Marla's looking for a Gucci
Automan, 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 Automan. Hey. It's your cue, Chuck.
Thank you. Well, I wished I could match with that, but I was thinking food. Again, I said filet mignon.
Filet, all right.
Thanks.
What does Miss Sterling Silverhead say?
I couldn't think of the name of any of those little things they give dogs, those little goody things. But I thought filet mignon was an awful
filet,
good.
Yes, of course. Right. All right. Mike, you want to have a go at it?
Sure.
Here it is. Skinny Sam is so skinny. Thank you. The computer dating service fixed him up with a blank. That's how skinny he is.
All right. You might ask where Phyllis gets her hair cut.
Yeah, Phyllis, where do you get your hair cut?
At a sheet metal shop.
Right.
Rum job.
Columbo.
Rumbo.
All right, Mike.
Very good.
Skinny Sam is so skinny the computer dating service fixed him up with a blank.
A mop.
A mop.
A what?
That's good.
Well, a mop.
That's good.
He means
that's
a mop handle.
Very
is what
good.
I mean.
That's great. Good. That's good.
Right, he meant
that's
the mop
great.
Handle, you know, the stick part, which is skinny, not
and,
the...
And the other part is her hair. I recognize
right.
that.
Right. Naturally. What did you say, Leonard?
Well, I didn't say the right answer. I thought mine was good. Toothpick.
Toothpick is good?
You're very kind.
Symbol for skinniness.
Symbol for skinniness.
Right. Richard?
I don't know. My mind is on food because I just ate. You know, you sat next
yes,
to me.
Right.
I had the hash and you... I said string bean.
String bean, that's another symbol
good.
For skinniness.
Yeah.
Skinny symbols.
It's all skinny symbols.
String bean.
You had that too, right. Really?
It's weird.
Really, oy vey.
Oy vey.
Yes. Oy vey.
Or a matzo, either yeah, one. Right. Been skinny.
But who knew?
Who knew?
Okay, John. You're
yeah?
picking your teeth?
Yeah. Toothpick.
Toothpick it is. Mike is still looking for a mop.
I too said toothpick.
Toothpick. Mop handle. Little mop handle for...
No, I'm wrong. Flagpole.
Flagpole.
Yeah.
That's skinny. So there we are at the end of round one. Neither one of you scored. It's 0-0. Round two, right after this for you.
It's going.
Here we go with round two. Now, since we have a tie score, the rule states that the person who did not go first last time goes first when the score is tied. That's you, Mike.
Let's try A.
Let's try A. You sure? That's this one.
That's that one.
All right, Mike. Weird Willie's Furniture Store sells the world's weirdest furniture.
How weird is
it? I'll tell you. The beanbag chairs are filled with blank beans.
Oh, that's simple.
Okay, Leonard? Sure. Mike, Weird Willie's Furniture Store sells the world's weirdest furniture. The beanbag chairs are filled with blank beans.
Jelly beans.
Jelly beans is one possibility.
That's it. That's gotta be it.
You see, that's a good answer for this year. But 10 years from now, when this show is rerun, they'll say, what the heck did he say jelly beans for?
Right.
What do you say?
Oy vey. Oy vey. Like the Jewish lady who went to the Gentile country club and she was dancing on the floor and slipped and said, oy vey, whatever that means. Anyhow,
yes.
I said the Mexican jumping beans.
Jumping beans.
This is wrong.
Hey, goody.
Oy vey.
You got it too. That's two jumping beans.
Yeah.
So bravo.
Thank you. All right. Next chorus rehearsal will be...
Okay, Mike. Great minds think alike.
You got it.
Jelly bean.
Jelly bean. Wow.
Thank you.
So it's 1-0 in Mike's favor, John.
Da 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 da. Automan.
I hate to encourage this kind of nonsense, but I said jumping beans.
Yes.
Oh, this is terrible. Jumping beans.
You must learn the words.
I
you don't know the words here.
Aren't those the words?
Those are the words.
We get René out.
The words are, there's something about a martini, a taste delightfully pleasant. There's something about a martini, how I wish that I had one at present.
Oh, yeah!
All right.
Marla.
Gracious, nuts. That's why I'm here.
All right, here we go.
Here we go.
In the Smithsonian Institute... The tour guide said,
and here we have the world's smallest book. It's entitled, My Accomplishments in Politics. It's written by blank.
Oh. Oh. Oh, gave you a meaty one.
Oh, gee.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Ah.
Right.
Oh, no.
Right. Here we go. Phyllis, you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Put it in the slot.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Good.
Marla, in the Smithsonian Institute tour guide, said, and here we have the world's smallest book. It's entitled, My Accomplishments in Politics. It's written by blank.
Richard Nixon.
Mm. Richard Nixon. I think they're about... Two or three good choices here.
He
that's
accomplished
one.
A lot. Not very good, but he accomplished a lot. True. I wish I had the missing tapes. If I had the missing tapes, I'd do it. If I had the missing... I said the another fella.
Ronald Reagan. All right.
Sorry, four.
What's wrong with that?
Hey. Yeah.
You go to your shul and I'll go to mine.
Richard?
I wanted to remain apolitical because, who knows, I might have a career after the show.
No way.
So I said Billy Carter, who's the president's brother. Billy Beer and all that.
Written by, all right.
Sorry.
What have you got?
Well, do I have to?
You got a show.
I thought that she would say Ronald Reagan, but I'm right. Remaining apolitical.
She said Richard Nixon.
Yeah,
it's all right.
That
it's
was
okay.
My thinking exactly. You know, you go for the most current flop, and I pick Ronnie.
Right. Where did you get all these Republicans, Gene?
Let's be wishy-washy.
We bring them in by the busloads, Gene.
Yeah, I guess so.
We bust in all the Republicans.
All those rich folk out there. What do you say, Chuck?
Well, Gene, I said Ronald Reagan because we're trying to match, but I don't believe that he's not accomplished anything.
Then you shouldn't have written it.
Automan. Automan.
Phyllis.
You know, I have an answer that actually makes sense.
You have an answer that makes sense?
Yes, I do.
The only one so far.
That's right.
What's that?
Alexander Haig.
Uh-huh. Secretary of State for 20 minutes? Right. Well, there we are. 1-0. Real tight game going here, isn't it? Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. Round 3, final round right after this. Mike, you're ahead. That means you go first.
Let's try A again.
A again? All right. Everyone except Lydia.
Oh.
You matched in the previous round. All right. Now, you've all heard about those exercise books about how to flatten your stomach in 30 days. Have you heard of them?
Yes.
Well, Weird Willie has just written a book called How to Flatten Your Blank in 30 Seconds. Weird Willie. Right?
Blank.
Yes.
I'm
Weird
wrong,
Willie.
But I'm quick.
Right.
Yeah.
Here we go. Mike, now you've heard about those exercise books, How to Flatten Your Stomach in 30 Days. Well, Weird Willie has written a book called How to Flatten Your Blank in 30 Seconds.
Face.
Face, he said. Flatten your face.
Thank you, man.
Boing. All right.
29 seconds left.
Yep.
Mike has a nice red face because he's an outdoor man, and I have a nice red face because I did have a martini. I like my answer, but it's wrong. What else is new? Wife.
Wife is good.
Oh. Oh.
Thank you. You're very kind.
It's Weird Willie. You forgot. It's Weird Willie. Yes?
I don't like my answer because I have a darling mother-in-law, but I thought perhaps he would say mother-in-law.
Right. He didn't say that. He said face. Lydia, you don't play. John, what have you got?
Well, see, after all those many years of sitting in class like this in order to try to change the shape of my nose, the only thing I could think of that I would want changed is my nose!
Well, how to flatten your nose
yeah.
in 30 seconds.
Besides, Weird Willie's oriental. Yeah.
That's true. I was thinking if you fell and hit your nose, that would match.
How to flatten your nose
two.
In 30 seconds. With
mouth and throat.
Yeah.
Well, I could only think of two things that I was going to vote for. One was feet and the other was head.
How to flatten your head in 30 seconds. Now, Mike.
Tough question.
You didn't improve your position at all there. That puts her in a good spot. All she needs is one to tie and two to win. Harry's strip joint is so cheap.
How cheap is it?
I'll tell you, the strippers all have to share one blank. That's how cheap it is. Strippers share one blank. Can you hear me? Is my mic working? All right. Hello, Marla.
Hi.
Harry's strip joint is so cheap, the strippers all have to share one blank.
G-string?
She says G-string. All right, one to tie and two to win, Marla. Here we go.
If you gotta
bump it with the G-string.
Nice score. If you show a G-string, she wins.
She wins. The show's over.
G-string wins the game. Okay, there's your mark right there. All right, yay. Hey, Mike. A pleasure to meet you, and we'll send some gifts to you from the match game.
Thank you.
You'll love them.
Thank you.
Mike Gill, there he goes. How do you feel?
Great.
Good.
Super.
Well, now you're going to go on here. We're going to switch to Hollywood Squares, and to do that, we'll have to bring out three more celebrities, and the rest of the set is coming into place. John and I will change places, and we've got lots more excitement coming your way. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Montgomery Ward's coordinated 4.1 cubic foot compact refrigerator microwave oven, a space-saving combination with microwave turntable and glide-out shelves in freezer, furnished by Montgomery Ward. And now, it's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Squares, our win from Falcon Crest, Abby Dalton. From Hill Street Blues, René Enríquez. Charles Nelson Reilly. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bowman.
We'll be back in just a moment. And we will play the Hollywood Squares.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Squares.
Well, we're in the middle. It's kind of an unusual day for Marla because she runs 8 miles a day and she hasn't gotten her running in yet today. So I'm just helping her out here. She did run away with the match game. And now, can we stop? Thanks. Now we're ready to play Hollywood Squares. We have three brand new celebrities. Charles Nelson Reilly.
Hello.
René Enríquez. Can you finish this? Abby Dalton. Okay, you do the interview. Yeah. René, star, one of the many stars of Hill Street Blues, and one of the most illustrious. I wanted to ask you, how many languages do you speak, René?
Besides none.
Well, that was my next question. Is English one of them?
Well, no, English is half. I speak Spanish and... Spanish. Spanish.
I see.
That's all.
Well, let's run over here and play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. Sweet. We will reacquaint ourselves with our defending... Hey, keep it Kline over there, guys.
Okay.
And in English. We will reacquaint ourselves with our defending champion. Her name is Patty Finley. Her total, she has had two very big days here on our show. Her total is $24,975.
Three days.
Now, are you relieved? Are you relaxed? Are you satisfied?
Oh, I'm more than satisfied, but I'm going to keep going.
Right, you got to keep plugging. She's won 10,000 one day and 20,000 another day, right?
No. 10,000.
Oh, yeah, 10,000 one day and 10,000 the other day. And, of course, assorted Hollywood Squares winnings along the way. But we're going to play this game until she hears the Time's Up bell. And at that point, she may go on to play Supermatch for another up to $30,000. On the other hand, Marla could be the one. Our first game's worth $100, $25 for every square. Patty, start us off.
Richard, please.
Hi.
Yeah.
Hi, John.
Where am I, Richard?
Bend me, shape me, any way you want me. Fire away.
According to a survey in Glamour magazine, Richard, have most office workers had an office romance? Or have they never cavorted with a coworker?
Glamour, huh? It's right there on my shelf in the bathroom. I would say that most of people who have a job in an office have at one time or another been involved in a flagrante delectatio, which means meet me in the storeroom for a little whoops-e. So I would say yes. What was the question? Do they not?
You've said that most office workers have had an office romance.
Oh, absolutely. What the heck else is there to do there except use a correcto type?
What do you say, Patty?
I disagree.
According to the survey in Glamour magazine, most office workers have had an office romance.
Patty.
You should have agreed with Richard Clyde.
Baby.
And your opponent gets the first square.
Meet me backstage.
Meet me in his office. Marla, your move for an O.
Charles.
Okay.
Ha! Go ahead. Ask me anything.
You're a robber crab from the Indian Ocean.
See, another one of these. A robber crab?
Yeah, that's you. Why do you climb trees, Charles? Is it to eat the coconuts?
Or?
Or to jump out of the trees and commit suicide?
No help from the panel. Well, actually, what is the name of that animal that runs off cliffs?
Lemmings.
I think that it's possible they go up and jump off to commit suicide.
Do they leave
financial problems. A flounder could have given him trouble. Who knows? Who cares? Committing suicide, go with B. But on my track record, I haven't done this well this week.
Broken heart.
Agree or disagree, Marla, that the robber crabs climb trees to commit suicide?
I agree.
Robber crabs from the Indian Ocean climb trees to eat the coconuts. You should have disagreed with Charles. Your opponent gets that square, and we have an even-up match. That was a lovely bunch of
roll.
Coconuts. For you, my dear, you are playing X. Pick a star.
A heart-sick crab.
You're consistent, Charles.
Abby, please.
Abby Dalton.
I haven't gotten over that one yet.
You've got mold on your jelly.
I didn't know you knew that. And you promised you wouldn't tell. You said you'd keep it a secret.
Now, does the Encyclopedia of Household Hints suggest you shave it off with an electric razor? Mold on your jelly.
Mold on my jelly.
Yeah. You either should shave it off with an electric razor or burn it off with brandy.
That's the silliest thing I've ever heard. You'd ruin your razor. It would all be full of jam. It has to be burn it off with brandy, although I don't think either one of them are true.
What do you say, Patty?
One of them is.
One of them suggested, anyway. You burn it off with brandy. Yes, you were right to agree. Very well done. Okay.
That's right.
We got a wacky game going. We'll find out what happens after this.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Still enthusiastic after all these days. While you're ahead and enthusiastic, you're behind, but not by much. It's your move.
René to block.
Okay, René Enríquez.
What did John J. Audubon usually do with a bird after he painted its picture? Did he kiss the bird and let it fly free? Or did he eat it?
Oh, yeah.
Who asked you?
No, he certainly kissed and let him go free.
Okay. For an important block, agree or disagree, Marla?
I agree.
After John J. Audubon painted a bird's picture, he usually ate it. You should have disagreed with René. Your opponent gets the square and wins the first game. Is that unbelievable?
See, the bird was already dead. No, I'm serious. The bird.
Wait. Leonard has some information on this. Leonard?
This is true. The bird was already dead. You couldn't get a bird to pose, to stand absolutely still for 6 days. The bird was already dead, so what are you going to do?
Well,
you can't kiss a dead bird.
You're going to eat it after it's been dead for 6 days?
The vultures were a little
tough. Let's take the X's and O's off of the board, and we're going to start a $200 game before this gets any further. Marla, you lost the last one. It is your turn to start this one.
Richard
Kline in the middle.
Yo, Marla.
It's time for baby Bernie to be circumcised, Richard.
Oy vey.
Oh, no.
Is it typical for him to get anesthesia? Or does baby Bernie go without?
You know, the technical name for this, of course, is a bris. Do they leave here or what?
They're Republicans. They don't understand what you're talking about.
And at a bris, the person who performs it is called a moil. The bus will stay, believe me. I have never seen a moil use anesthesia. The kid just sits there and screams bloody murder.
Okay, Marla, agree or disagree that you've never seen a moil use that? I mean, that there's no anesthesia for baby Bernie.
I agree.
There is no anesthesia for baby Bernie. You are right to agree. You get the square.
That's why there's so many messed up men in the world.
Hurts.
Richard Kline and his wife, incidentally, recently had a baby, a girl.
Girl.
Yes. Well done.
Yes.
Patty, your move.
Abby, please.
Abby Dalton.
Yes.
We've all heard about Ma Barker and her gang. How did she really die? Was she in a shootout with the FBI? Or did her oven blow up while she was baking a pie?
Ma Barker. It seems to me that I remember her getting into a terrible gunfight, and it was the FBI.
Agree or disagree, Patty?
I'm going to agree.
Ma Barker died in a shootout. You were right to agree, and you get the square. I know. I would have loved it if her oven baked up while she was baking a pie.
Her souffle fell.
But it didn't. Marla, your move, you're playing O.
Charles.
Okay.
The crab.
I'm committed. Crying about that bird mass murderer. And all those little Jewish boys going, this is a terrible program. Get your heart out, Patty Duke.
This will cheer you up, Charles. I can cheer you up right here. Which came
now
first?
Now I'll get another wrong answer, but I'd like to give an overture.
Which came first, Dom DeLuise or the electric refrigerator?
It's very close. It's like the Shelley Winters question. Boy, is this close. I will go with the electric Frigidaire by an hour and a half. One is 50. I was there when he was 50.
Agree or
he had a nervous
Marla.
Breakdown. The other one is about 58.
Okay, Charles says the refrigerator came first.
I agree.
The refrigerator came first. Ah! Yes, you're right, you agree. You get the square. The refrigerator was invented in 1910. Dom DeLuise invented more than 20 years later. We will find out what happens in the game that we have going. Remember that right after these messages. See you then. Let's... $200 for the champ, $75 for the challenger, but plenty of time, and we're in a $200 game. Patty, it is your move.
Phyllis to block, please.
Right. If you miss this one, Marla will take the game and the lead. Phyllis Diller. According to Cosmopolitan's new etiquette guide, is makeup in bed a must? Or is this the one time when you can let a man see you as you really are?
We all remember what that was.
I came out one morning to pick up the paper without makeup, and the guy across the street was mowing his lawn. He cut off his foot.
Ew. You could have had him give you a haircut in that thing while he was at it.
I just don't know about Cosmopolitan. That makes it difficult. I'm going to say that knowing Helen Gurley Brown, she will say to leave the makeup on.
Agree or disagree to block, Patty?
I disagree.
According to Cosmopolitan's new etiquette guide, makeup in bed is a must. Phyllis doped it out, and you should have agreed with her. Your opponent gets that square and wins the game. Yeah. Because it's Helen Gurley Brown, it kind of makes sense to me. Okay, that gives you the lead, Marla. Take the X's and O's off the board once again. And we got a very tight one going. $300 game coming up. Patty, you get to start.
Richard, please.
Okay. Richard Kline, in the Woody Woodpecker comic books.
He is.
Go ahead. Sorry. Does Woody have a girlfriend? Or does he peck that wood all by himself?
You're talking about Woody's girlfriend, Patty Pecker? How many woodchucks? All right. I think Woody is one of the great Walter Lance bachelors, meaning that he's out there alone. Pecking away.
No girlfriend.
No girlfriend.
Agree or disagree, Patty?
I agree.
Woody Woodpecker has a girlfriend. You should have disagreed with Richard, and your opponent gets that square. Little known fact, her name is Winnie Woodpecker.
Winnie?
Winnie? Winnie Woodpecker.
Winnie?
Winnie Woodpecker. Marla, pick a star.
Gene.
All right.
Gene Rayburn.
Yes, sir. Reed.
According to a survey in Ladies' Home Journal, the biggest problem in a 25-year-old woman's marriage is money. What is the biggest problem in a 55-year-old woman's marriage?
Money.
Money?
Or
sex?
In a 55-year-old woman's marriage?
You got it.
Well.
Be careful.
I'm going to stick with the money.
What do you say, Marla? Agree or disagree?
I agree.
According to the survey in Ladies' Home Journal, sex is the biggest problem in a 55-year-old woman's marriage. Hey, the audience seems to agree. Okay. Like to see what goes on that bus on the way home. Patty, pick a star where you'd like to place an X.
Charles, please.
Okay, Charles Nelson Reilly.
I bet that Audubon guy ate Winnie Woodpecker. He ate everybody else. No wonder he's a bachelor.
Charles, you're an aging Beverly Hills widow, and you're writing your will.
Uh-huh.
Can you leave everything to your cat? Or will that invalidate your will?
Believe it or not, I think you can leave it to your cat.
Agree or disagree, Patty?
I agree.
You can leave everything to your cat.
Yes. Only in Beverly Hills.
It's our first right answer in a while. You're right to agree, and you get the square. So, lots hangs in the balance, Marla. Pick a star.
Leonard to block.
You missed this one. The lead goes back to
Leonard Pat. Fry to block. Oh, I forgot to say. I love
Leonard,
billing.
You were in the middle of a state dinner at the White House, and you just remembered you left something important at home. If you run home to get it, will the Secret Service let you back in to say goodnight to Ron?
Good night, Ron.
Or is their policy, once you're out, you're out?
Well, the policy makes no sense. My face is legend. My career is a matter of theatrical history.
You tell him, kid.
If I go out, I should be coming back in, unless they'll stamp your head. No, of course.
So they'll let you back in?
Of course. Mr. Fry, right this way. Say goodnight to Nancy, too.
Okay, let's agree or disagree to block, Marla.
I disagree.
Okay, the Secret Service policy is once you're out, you're out. You are right to disagree, you get the square, and you do block.
Right this way, Mr. Fry.
Didn't matter,
so
Ron's asleep anyway. Patty, you are thwarted there. We got a very tight game going here. Let's keep it going. Patty, you are thwarted there. Make your move.
Lydia to block, please.
Okay, now you missed this one. It's the game and a pretty big lead to your opponent. Lydia Cornell, what makes the official Boy Scout handshake special? Do they do something extra with their thumbs, or do they do it left-handed?
Okay, who's a Boy Scout? They do something extra with their thumbs.
Agree or disagree to block, Patty?
I agree.
What makes the official Boy Scout handshake special is that they do it left-handed.
Oh,
you should have disagreed with Lydia. Your opponent gets that square, and your opponent wins another game. $675, new champ. Good sport. Zip your way over there, join Gene Rayburn. Get set for your shot at the big money. One way or another, a lovely woman in a red dress was going to be over there for a shot at the big money. It was you, although you weren't wearing that dress for the last 3 days or so. But today, it's not. You played very, very well. Your total, leaving here, $25,225. Big ones. You're terrific. Patty Finley.
Oh, very much. Thank you.
Gene, take it.
Okay, John, here we are with a champ, the new champ. We'll be back with her and the 9 stars for going the big goal right after this.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Gino, here we go. Thank you. Marla, you ready?
I'm ready.
This is your first time up here. You could win up to $30,000 here in the Super Match. Let's have a go at it, and good luck. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank Young. If you give us the answer that audience wrote down most often, it's $1,000, and then $500 for the second most popular and $250 for the third. All right, little sis from our stars. Whom do you call on?
Chuck.
Forever Young.
Robert, what?
Forever Young.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Forever Young. I'm sorry, was it the right
two term? People were talking and I misunderstood. He says Forever Young.
Lydia.
Robert Young.
All right, now you have two.
John.
I like those, but there's got to be another good one in here.
Yes.
Sorry about it. I'm going to say Loretta.
Loretta Young.
Loretta
Young, Academy Award winner.
All right, so you have Robert Young, Forever Young, and Loretta Young. You may choose one of those, or maybe you've got a better one.
Robert.
You want Robert. Robert Young.
What about Egg Foo?
All right. Robert Young, she hopes, is under the $1,000 response, but we'll look down at the bottom first and reveal the $250 number.
Oh, I know.
Too young.
Oh my God.
They tried to tell us we're too young.
Oh no!
Okay. The $500 response says,
"Yeah,
no,
Neil Young." You were trying to think of that one, right? All right, here's your last chance for Robert Young. Go, Steve! Yeah, you got it. Here it is. $1,000 for you.
Hey, Marla.
Okay.
I knew there was a modern one.
What about Egg Foo?
What's that?
Egg Foo.
Egg Foo Young, right. Anyway, she's got the $1,000. Now it's a head-to-head match with any star of her choosing. After you've made your decision, that star will reveal the hidden number. And we will multiply the $1,000 by whatever number is revealed at that time. Up there somewhere is 130. The others are all 10s and 20s. Time now to choose a star.
John.
All right, John. Ready, set, go. $10,000 is what you're playing for. $10,000. All right.
$10,000.
Good luck to you. Here it is. Blank Fork. F-O-R-K. Blank Fork.
What?
All right, Marla, we want you to collect the $10,000, but first you have to match John. What do you say?
Pitchfork.
Pitchfork. Very good. Well, the audience is yaying.
Boy,
that's apparently that's what they would say. John, she says pitchfork will match you for the 10 grand. What do you say?
It's pretty good.
Well, you're a farm boy from Brooklyn, aren't you?
I am a farm boy from Brooklyn. And that's why I said knife and fork.
Knife and fork. Well, listen, it hasn't been a total loss for you today. You know what you've got so far? $1,675. That's not bad.
I said knife and fork.
All right, we'll be back with our champ and the stars right after this. Here we go now. Let's find out which star has the big number. Would you all grab the tabs? Ready, set, go. Charles!
Can I just say, on behalf of everybody, but especially our icicle queen of 85 from El Segundo, a very Merry Christmas from Phyllis Diller and a Happy New Year to everyone.
All right, back to Tinseltown for Phyllis. Thank you, Star. See you tomorrow. See you
tomorrow,
Marla. Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Bowen saying, so long for the match game, Hollywood Squares Air. Say goodnight, Charles.
A member of our studio audience will receive 28 diamond Benrus fashion watch, adjustable Italian mesh bracelet, silver tone dial and case, precision 17 jewel movement, furnished by Benrus. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.